Again, thank you for joining us this morning for Coach Campbell's press conference. We're looking forward to the game tomorrow. Matt, good morning to you. Thank you for being here. Before we get your opening statement and get to their questions, this is one of our traditions here at the Office of Liberty Bowl for us to ask you a couple of things. First of all,
for the record, old Elvis or young Elvis, what's your preference?
I would say young Elvis. You know, nobody knows my, and maybe Randy needs to know this. This would be a fun fact for Randy here that covers us. But man, my greatest collection growing up was Dick Clark's Golden Oldies in the 60s. So I got them all, and so young Elvis probably is what I'd go with.
Now, you are a seasoned person coming to our city, second trip here as head coach with Iowa State. So you know the barbecue scene. Preference, dry ribs, wet ribs, little of both?
Yeah, I'm a dry rib guy. I'm a dry rib guy for sure. So, but enjoy a little bit of both for sure.
And with that, thoughts on the week, how it's been for your team, the bowl experience for you and your football team?
Yeah, honestly, you know, we being our second time as a football program here, you just have such a sense of gratitude for, honestly, Harold, you, your staff, the commitment that this city makes to this bowl game. It makes it really special to be a part of it. I know myself, everybody associated with our program, it's been a really special week for us.
Well, thank you. Any other opening comments on the week of practice and the game?
No, other than, you know, it's been a journey. I think 27 days since this bowl game got announced, and excited to get into, you know, the opportunity to put the last 24 hours kind of together and get ready to go play a great football game. So we look forward to the challenge and certainly get a lot of respect for the opponent we get to play.
We'll take questions. We have a mic to pass. George has the mic. Hands up. We'll go to the front row, just like our tradition here.
Nice.
Randy?
Yes.
Randy gets the first question.
Great.
You're the Helen Thomas of the media delegation this morning, something like that. The old folks don't know what I'm referring to.
Old Elvis. Old Elvis.
So who has to play well for you guys in order to do it?
Well, I would just say, as young as we are, Randy, you know, collectively this football team has to handle not playing a football game for an entire month. You know, I think when you look at the calendar, it's been an entire month since the last time we played a football game. And I just think these new experiences for this, as young as we are as a football team right now, handling bowl prep, handling, leaving home, handling even the last 24 hours, we just talked about that. You know, you get excitement of our fan base getting down here and you know, just getting to game day. So I just think collectively we're going to have to play a great football game, and our youth is going to have to be able to show the maturity that it takes to be able to play really well after a month off. So I think we look forward to that as coaching staff, and look forward to the challenge at hand.
Yesterday, John kind of, you didn't hint at, he said it's been remarkable how many young people have, really young players have contributed. And he said at times, I think he said something like he'd do a double take of who we're throwing in there, and they're performing well. How has that impressed you this season? And also, of course, in bowl prep, you get a lot more young guys that haven't had that experience getting more reps in practice.
I think we'll at some point we'll be able to sit back and reflect on this season, and I think what's been done has been nothing short of incredible. I mean, the guys that have stood up and played meaningful snaps, and the stories that I think will come out of this season, and there's going to be some guys that are going to be in that same boat tomorrow, and you know, the ability to be ready for when their number was called. I just think that to me has been what's been remarkable about this season. And you know, it started obviously in May for us, where some of the challenges that can come with the college football season came, and you know, really put the onus on a lot of young guys to be ready to step up and be ready when their number got called. And you know, we we had the courage and the commitment from our leadership, in my opinion, which, you know, our coaching staff and our seniors that had, they were great givers, and they had the ability. I think true leadership is when you have the ability to inspire others around you. And, you know, the coaching staff, and I really think our senior leadership was nothing short of incredible during this journey so far.
And I know, you know, experiences have been big for this team from the retreat before the season. You guys go to the Civil Rights Museum again. I know you took the team in 2017 as well. How powerful was that for your guys to, you know, to see a much bigger slice of what, you know, life is about, and challenge and adversity and all those things?
Well, I think we, you know, sometimes we lose our way in college football. In a lot of ways, we really have, right? But the greatest joy and the greatest gift that we're still given as leaders of young men is building a young man into a man. And, you know, I think when you can use the lessons of the sport of football, and then one of the great things about these bowl trips is you can get to some of these historic places and you see where real change has occurred. And you see where real leaders have stood up and led the way. Those are things we teach on a day-in, day-out basis, but to see it where, you know, our mission is should be in coaching, and again, we've lost our way, but it should be to create young men 22, 23 years old to leave our programs and go create change, go lead communities, go be great fathers, go be great husbands, have the ability to make an impact on this world. And I still think football is still a sport. It's team sport. Not one person can dictate the outcome of a game. It's a team that has to win, and that's really life, right? Team creates change. Groups create change, not one person. And that's one of the powerful things about our sport, and I think the ability to give real-life experiences to our kids, give our young people the opportunity to feel and see that, it's awesome. And it's awesome to be able to create those teachable moments and to reflect on those. And I think for a lot of our guys, yesterday was a really powerful day, as it was, you know, 6 years ago. But I was really proud of our kids, and I think our staff really enjoyed it. Our kids really enjoyed it. It was a really great day for us.
I'm at Frank Bonner with the Daily Memphian. Speaking of youth, you've got a young quarterback leading the way. Just how have you seen him respond to the highs and lows of this year?
Yeah, you know, I think probably that's, if I'm proudest of one thing, it's his ability to handle that. You know, playing quarterback is never, it doesn't always go like this, and it never will. It's always a roller coaster of good days and bad days. And the great ones that we've had the ability to coach and I've had the fortune to be around, they've got this unique ability to be the same guy every day. And they've got a humbleness about them that they know that their best is yet to come. But yet they also have the courage and commitment to, you know, give credit to others when they deserve the right to have the credit. And, you know, I think we're really fortunate to see Rocco's just maturity. Who he is makes him even greater than what he's done on the football field. I think how he's led since May in our football program, in our locker room, you know, when we were 1-2 and things didn't look great for us early in the season, I think his confidence and commitment to process and team, I think that was rallying points for our football program. And, you know, to me, great quarterback play is far greater than anything to do with arm talent. It has everything to do with maturity, character, and the ability to be a great leader. And Rocco's certainly shown great wisdom beyond his years for a young quarterback so far.
Concrete mistakes that or reads that weren't necessarily made in the beginning of the year and heading into now, you can kind of see where some of those have been fixed throughout the year?
Yeah, you know, I think the biggest thing, if you look back at some of our games, you know, Rocco hasn't always been perfect. But I think one of the things that's been really fun is just his ability to make those corrections even in the game. His ability to, man, I made a mistake in the game, and his his unique ability to rally back and to correct that mistake, whether, you know, it's an incompletion or an interception or even maybe how he handled a situation, and that situation's come back to him, and his ability in game to self-correct. I think that's been really impressive. I give a lot of credit to Coach Shielhouse, you know, our quarterback coach and coordinator, but, you know, I give a lot of credit to Rocco. I think, again, you got to have great humility, you got to want to be teachable, and you got to want to have the ability to grow, and he certainly has all those great qualities.
I don't know if this is Jonah Dillon, Commercial Appeal. I know that you and Coach Silverfield kind of crossed over for a minute at Toledo. Just curious what you remember about that and then what your relationship with him has been like since then.
Yeah, you know, Ryan came on board, I think our last year at the University of Toledo, came on board as a quality control coach off the field and came from, you know, at his time, I think at the Minnesota Vikings is where he was prior to that. And, you know, I think the one thing you knew about Ryan, and it was only about 6 months, it was that season, we had a great season there, and I think Ryan just brought energy and certainly brought, you know, great football intelligence to our football program at the time. You know, we were fortunate because we had a really good football team, but, you know, Ryan's experiences in the NFL and some of his own experiences, I think, really were an asset to our football program. And, you know, certainly have followed him. I think he left right after our season at Toledo when we came to Iowa State. He came to Memphis and had the opportunity to be the offensive line coach, and it's been fun to watch Ryan grow. You know, I think he's done a great job. You watch his football team play, really in all three phases of the game. They're an exceptional football team, and just a lot of respect for what he's about and certainly how he takes care of kids and treats humans.
And then obviously a unique situation here playing against a team that's going to play in this bowl game in their home stadium. What is the, like, when you're preparing for the game, how do you get your players, you know, obviously it's all different, it's a bowl game, it's different than usual, but then you have that kind of added caveat. How does that factor into your preparation?
Yeah, you know, I'm probably the guy that really puts his onus more on our own team, you know, and you can't control some of the factors that you know, kind of come your way, but what you can control is yourself. And, you know, we try to put a lot of time and effort into those things. But, you know, obviously a really talented Memphis team who's played really, really great football at home. And so it'll be a really good challenge for this team. And, you know, we've also been a team that's been fortunate late in the season to play really well on the road. So I think we kind of look at it. I think naturally going to a bowl game, sometimes you look at it as an away game anyway. So, you know, I think a lot of ways you kind of try to replicate that process.
We're going to go to Randy, then we'll go to you.
Matt, when this game tomorrow comes down to a field goal, what gives you the confidence that Chase can make that field goal?
Well, I think, again, I think one of the huge pieces of success of our football team is just Chase's growth. I mean, you know, he's been a difference maker. And when I talk about senior leadership, you know, even just getting into our program in May, he's brought wisdom, he's brought process, and he's brought a standard for excellence that I think he's raised the level of excellence in our specialist room. And, you know, I think how he's performed, how you watch that guy practice every day, those are the things that have given us great confidence in him. And so just really proud of what he's done, has certainly left a great legacy and a profound impact on the future of our specialist room.
Matt, in Central Iowa, everyone, I guess, knew about Abu Sama and the way he played, and, you know, from that state championship game. What has it been like for you and your staff for him to kind of burst on the scene, and now a national audience is seeing just how good he is?
Well, I think for Abu, you know, I just go back to a little bit of his recruiting journey. You know, I think it was a little bit quiet. There were so many talented players on his team as his going into his junior year. And, you know, I think one of the great things that you loved about Abu's videotape is just what a great competitor he is. You know, we then had him in camp, and probably was one of the best camp performances, but it was at corner that we had ever seen. And then you flash forward about 6 months and you watch him in that state championship game and you're like, geez, how do you not start this guy at tailback and let this guy, you know, start off there? And again, to me, the great thing about Abu is he's earned everything that he's ever gotten. You know, he's kind of had to come up the recruiting rough side of the mountain, who he is, what his family's about, you know, what they're what their mission in life is. I think that's what makes Abu really special, and I think he's going to have a chance to tell a really powerful story as his career continues to move forward. But I think he's really easy to root for because of who he is, you know, and we've been really fortunate to watch his journey.
Hey, Matt. I think you've spoken on this before, so just indulge me if you could, please. We're in an era where bowl games are facing some challenges as far as interest and things of those nature. It's probably only going to get more challenging for these bowl games when the playoff expands. For your program and the fan base, why do you think that this still matters? Because it seems clear that it does still matter to Cyclones.
Yeah, well, I would hope it does. You know, I think that, you know, yes, there's an era of change. Where we land here over the course of the next couple of years will be fascinating. But, I mean, you take even in a tremendous venue in the history of this great bowl game and the Liberty Bowl and certainly the history of college football and the great players that have played and the great coaches that have coached in this game and the great games that have been played. I just think there's such a huge factor for postseason football when you've earned the right to be in the postseason. And, you know, I think the growth of any football team, especially when you're still building programs like we do, you know, we're a football program, not a football team, and try to do a great job of using those practices to continue to enhance the future of your football team. And, you know, unfortunately, we've become a society of instant gratification, especially even in college football. But the reality of it is football is still a developmental sport, and developmental time is critical for football teams. And I think these bowl games give that developmental time a great opportunity to continue to move teams and programs forward. So that'd be my answer. I think you're right, though. It's certainly a unique and interesting time in this landscape for sure.
Hey, Coach, thinking back to mid-September, just a day or two after that Ohio loss, is this a spot that you ever envisioned the program would be just a couple months later?
Yeah, you know, I'll be honest with you. I'm a guy that has great optimism when I believe that the programs align correctly. And, you know, I also think can be a realist too. But I'll be really honest, I felt like even in May and June that this team had a chance to be really special. I didn't know how that was going to happen, quite honestly, and I didn't know why it was going to happen other than just how I watched our kids work, what they stood for. I really thought our kids had a really great fall camp, and I knew it would take time. You know, I think some of our local media is here, and, you know, as I told them, you know, it's a journey. And especially when you're as young as we were and as many young guys, and we played some really veteran teams early on. I mean, you know, you look at some of those teams and the seasons that they had, they were playing, you know, with great veteranness to themselves. And I still think you reflect back, we didn't play bad football in those games. You know, maybe we didn't get the result we wanted, but it wasn't, you know, where we weren't playing to football that you didn't think you were growing. And that's the thing that's been fun about this team is every week of the football season, we've gotten better. And I don't know if, you know, at least during my time here, that's ever truly happened. But this group, this has happened. And, you know, again, we got one more great opportunity, hopefully, to grow forward tomorrow. But this group's done a great job of growing. That's probably what's given me so much belief in them.
Matt, I think going back to the college football landscape and that aspect, over the past few years, December has kind of become this war room, I guess, of a calendar month for you guys. What would you like to see change about the college football calendar, like day of signing day? And I don't want to put words in your mouth, but what would you like to see change about that?
Yeah, you know, I just – there's – it probably would take me a while to sit down and give you – I think anything you're going to say right now is going to be reactionary. I think the reality of it is we're very chaotic. And, you know, there's a lot of chaos in college football right now. And unfortunately, when there's chaos, you know, who can get hurt is 18 to 22-year-olds that are really responsible to serve. And so I think, you know, we just got to figure out where all of this is going to land and try to put the best rules and regulations around what the new landscape looks like. But at the end of the day, it's still college football. It's still dealing with 18 to 22-year-olds, and it's still trying to create a great team each and every fall. And so You know, I think trying to navigate through that is certainly a challenge, but you know, I think we like challenges, and part of the challenge is you got to try to find the best clarity for yourself, and you shouldn't have to try to be like somebody else. You should just try to be the best version of you and see what that looks like. But yeah, I think it's a great question. It's a question probably I ask at times too to other people, but I wish I had a better answer right now. I think, you know, as things, even after this season digests, I can give you a better answer maybe in the spring.
One last question right here. Right here? Okay, last question.
Hey, Matt, I know you said health-wise going into this, we're in pretty good shape. What's Malik's status for this and anything else kind of along the way that's popped up?
No, I think Malik is, you know, I would just say questionable. I mean, has been able to practice for us, and so that part's been really positive. You know, I would say everybody else, we've been really fortunate. You know, it's been really good time for us. I think goal number one after the season was try to get healthy, and I think we were able to do that really well, which was huge. I don't know if we'd been in that situation, you know, most of the, especially the last half of the football season, and for us to be able to get there, I thought that was really big, and then continue to grow forward, and I think we're able to really work on those two things.
Matt, thank you. Let's do a quick photo op, you with the trophy, if awesome. You will.
Yep.